Hello everyone, I am Josh, and welcome to this Sims 3 house building video. So, in the spirit of it being summer and feeling like over 100 degrees outside, I have decided to build a beach house, which I've entitled Summer Beach House, a very creative name indeed. So, this house is built on the beach in Sunset Valley, so this is a custom placed lot. You can kind of tell where it is, it's by those rocks, like to the right of the beach in Sunset Valley, if you look like from the water into the town, if you know what I mean. But yeah, so this is a beach house. It's over the water. For the like 90% of it of the house is over the water, which is pretty cool. And I do put a boat on the back of the house. Well, I don't put a boat on the house, but next to the house in the water, so your Sims can also go boating, which is very nice indeed. And yeah, so this house has 3 bedrooms and 3.5 bathrooms, so it's a fairly decent sized house. And you're probably wondering how I managed to make a 3-bedroom house into a, what is this, a 40 minute or it's like 37 minute house build. Well, you know what? I take my time, so, you know, let's just sit back and relax. It's a relatively long house build. At least it's not 2 parts like a lot of my Sims 3 builds are. I don't know, so that's good, but anyway. Yeah, once we get to the roofing part, you'll see why this build took quite a while. So you can see here, there's a wraparound porch goes all the way around the house. And, you know, it's pretty nice. I think that with the stilts, it looks better to have that wraparound porch. And here I'm just putting in some columns, to go with the railing. And I just kind of, I'm placing a bunch of columns around the place. And you can see here, we have the structure of the house. There's going to be a second floor. And the second floor is partially obscured by the roof. You know, it looks pretty nice. I also put on a thatched roof and all the classic islandy touches. And here I'm just putting in the flooring. And yeah, you'll see here, we're very close, right here. Here we go. So we're starting with the roofing. And I did, with this house, a style that I've done a couple times before. I think the other house I've done that's most similar to this one is Winter Getaway, I believe the name is. I did that around Christmas time. And that house had a similar roof to this one with these, you know, large gabled roofs that kind of overhang the porches, and there's like a second floor slash balcony kind of hidden in them. Yeah, the roofs on this house, I think you pronounce it roofs. I don't know how you spell that. I don't know if there's a V in there. I presume there is. I don't know. I've never had to actually write out the word roofs. I've only ever said it, but anyway, I'm a terrible speller, but it's okay. I mean, I can spell normal, like common words, but I don't know. Anyway, that's besides the point. The point was, it's a very complicated roof. So it took me, well, the first try, I kind of extended the roofs too far back and they kind of clip through the back of the house. You'll see that. So I had to redo them later on. And, you know, it's just kind of a pain because it's a mess, really. But what's cool is I like the fact I can at least do this, because obviously you can't do this in The Sims 4. But it's just a lot of work, and you can see here it gets a little messy at times. You'll see once I start putting in a bunch of different roofs here and there and everywhere. I don't know. Actually, you know what? Now I have to look up if the word is roofs or roofs, because maybe I'm just pronouncing it wrong. I can't believe I've been, you know, oh, jeez. I have to know now, because it could be embarrassing if I'm saying the wrong thing. I never thought about it, but who knows? Maybe it's one of those words I just pronounced wrong. Anyway, I think it's roofs. It's just roofs, isn't it? Why would I say roofs? I don't know why I'm saying that. Oh, wait. Hold on. Let me look up with it. Spell with a V. This is not even related to what I'm doing here. Oh, look. Here's a grammar website. Roofs versus roofs. Let's find out which one is correct on this website here. Roofs is the plural of roof in all varieties of English. Roofs is an old secondary form and still appears occasionally. So they're both words. Both work. Okay. See, I'm not stupid. Roofs is an old secondary form and it still appears occasionally by analogy along with other irregular plurals. Oh, there's a text. Okay. Oh, gosh. Okay. Do apologize. That's what happens when I pull out my phone during videos. Okay. Anyway, so now I know I'm not wrong saying roofs. I can totally say that. It's just a, It's an old-fashioned way, because, you know, I'm so old-fashioned. Anyway, I'll say roofs. Anyway, during that whole exploration of, in history, well, not really history, but, you know, that whole exploration of the word roofs and roofs, I have put in a lot of roofs, and we have a lot going on here. So, I was trying to obscure the second floor behind some of the roofs that are on the porches, you know, that kind of thing, because I thought it would kind of give it a more cozy look. I want it to look more like a bungalow, like a smaller kind of house. but it's still a fairly large house. You know, so I'm just adding these peaks here and there, and I think, oh yeah, I deleted the whole front sections, you can see that, because I put them too far in to the roof. Like, they went past, like, the back of that, like, not past, like, past the second floor, so they stuck out in the back, if that makes sense. You probably saw it. I wasn't looking at the video, but you probably saw it. And here I'm just redoing those, so it's a painstaking process, really. You know, I wasn't looking forward to doing it a second time, but it's alright. And yeah, I had kind of had to adjust them a little bit too, because it was like slightly too tall, so I had to like adjust all these little slivers of roof that are kind of intersecting each other there. A little annoying, but it's okay, and it looks really cool in the end, so I love the way it turned out. You know, it really has that cozy kind of bungalow look to it, and it just looks really good with a thatched roof as well. So you can see here I have a bunch of little roof bits, little wall bits from the roofs, and I'm just kind of, you know, getting the shape right. So you can see here, actually, I think it's done, at least on this side of the house, and you can see what that looks like. You'll see it better in the screenshots at the end, obviously, because we have some nice screenshots and all that. And I have to do it here. The diagonal part was not that much harder, so it wasn't a big deal. I do have a balcony on this side of the house in the roof eaves, so, you know, a little bit of extra fanciness, because there's a bedroom there. The other one's a bathroom, so, you know, it's kind of weird to have a balcony off a bathroom. I've done it before, but it's only because it just ends up that way, because I always build my houses from inside out, so outside in, not inside out, outside in. You can see here, I haven't touched the inside yet, and I've already built the entire outside, so if, like, one room is, like, a weird shape, I'm screwed. But none of the rooms turned out to be a weird shape in this house, so that's good. Anyhow, you can see here, yes, this roof was a pain because it did not want to work out. I had to raise it up a little bit more than I wanted to mask that weird protruding part, the top, but it's alright. You can see here we have the lovely wall pieces that kind of mold to the roof shape, and it looks rather fantastic. So here I'm just messing around with this annoying part, and eventually I just raised up the roof to hide it, and it should be all good and jolly from here on, hopefully. I think, you know, this roofing part was just the bit of a struggle, it was a bit of a struggle. You know, it was the only challenging part of this build. It's not challenging. It just takes a bit of time to get it right, because there's a lot of intricacies that have to be worked out with that. But it looks really cool in the end, so I'm happy with it. Anyway, we're almost done with the roofing. I'm just kind of touching it up here. I removed the back porch because I wanted to make it look a little bit nicer, so I moved the roof on the over the back porch. You can also see there's a part of the back porch area that kind of comes out from the rest of the house, and there's no railings there. I imagine that would kind of be an area where people could jump off into the ocean or something, and also the boat is moored there, so, you know, it'd be kind of difficult to climb over a railing and get into the boat, so decided against putting a railing there. And also it leaves for, like, allows for unobscured views of the water from the back of the house. You know, I just would hope that right now the ocean is at high tide, because if this is low tide, then this house would get flooded, because the water comes past the front of the house. You can see here the area where the stairs are kind of goes in, you know what I mean? You can see that here, it goes past the shoreline, so the house is really built, you know, past the shoreline here. You can see where it's on the very edge, especially on the left side there. You can see the water is actually in front of the house, so it's kind of interesting. You know, just don't want to be there during a tropical storm, you know, that would not be good. Unenjoyable at most. And you can see I'm actually changing the shoreline there. I'm bringing it forward a bit because I felt like it, so yeah. Anyway, here you can see just adding in some landscaping, just a small bit there. Just I always like to get an idea of what the landscaping kind of shape, like where the plants are going to go, I don't know. Obviously, there's not much, in real life, there wouldn't be much landscaping on a beach because it's sand, and you're like literally a few feet from the water, so I can't imagine there'd be dirt and plants and trees growing. Well, palm trees, yeah. So, you know, I put them there anyway because it looks nice, so. Oh well, you know, it's just my style of building. I like to have lots of landscaping. I went a little lighter on the landscaping on this build, though, just because I was trying to have a little bit of realism going on, you know? And yeah, excuse me while I take a sip of water. I always take a sip of water. Well, recently I've been taking sips of water in my videos because I just realized I don't know. I don't like talking for so long and then let my throat dry out, so. Although it hasn't been that long that we've been recording. It's only been, oh, it's been 10 minutes, wow. Time flies when you're doing a voiceover, I guess. Anyway, you can see here, we're doing the colors. So the colors are wood and this blue stucco. The wood I'm putting on the outside of the house, I do change the color a little bit, but I use that wood everywhere inside the house, and I love the kind of contrast of the vertical planks and the horizontal planks. I also do that inside too. You know, part of the room will have the horizontal planks and part of the room will have the vertical planks. I think it looks kind of cool. And you can see there's also parts of the walls are just pure stucco and parts are kind of a little bit wood and, you know, part stucco. I thought it was kind of cool. So, you know, it's kind of islandy too. I feel like the wood planks, like the whitewashed wood and oh, excuse me. And the stucco, like the blue stucco, I think goes really well together. And you can see here, I was putting a chimney in over on this side. There's two chimneys on this house, which are pretty nice. There's, I think, three fireplaces, which, I don't know, it feels kind of weird for a beach house to have fireplaces, but I thought it looked nice, so, you know. Anyway, we're moving to the interior, and this is the dining room here in the front, and this is the living room we're looking at. Oh, well, kind of-ish. I was going to change out the front door, but then decided against it, so I put the front door back. Okay, so this is the dining room here, where this is the living room, and, yeah, this is the dining room. There's the living room. And with the piano in it, obviously. All my houses have piano. Then the back there is a breakfast room. Then there, I just enclosed the study. That's the kitchen I just enclosed. And then I'm going, and the front room there is a bonus room. So, actually, plenty of room. So you have a study, you have a breakfast room, you have a formal dining room, a living room, and then you have a bonus room, and then obviously the kitchen. And then there's three bedrooms and three bathrooms upstairs. So this house actually is pretty big. It's also pretty expensive too. I'm not sure what the price is right now. I think the final house I think is about 190. No, is it more than 200,000? I'm not sure. We'll see near the end of the video. Obviously, there's no furnishings yet, so it's going to be much lower. And right there, I just added a dormer to that bedroom, and that's the master bathroom I'm putting in right now. And that's obviously the master bedroom is next to it. And then we have two more bedrooms. One's a kid's room, and then one is a guest bedroom. So, yeah. And here you can see I'm putting in a bit of a shed dormer roof there for the master bathroom windows. Some of the windows are unfortunately small because just the roof didn't allow for a larger window, but it's all right. And I also put a balcony off the master bedroom that faces the water, which is very nice. You'll see some screenshots of that at the end. So very fancy indeed. And here you can see putting in some windows and doors. Got these lovely French doors, these arch doors that kind of go around the back of the house, and also some nice large windows, obviously. And then putting in some more windows, more large windows. And this house, lots of light in it, which is very nice. You can see there's lots of light, especially in the living room and dining room. There's so much, and also the breakfast room is basically all windows. There's so much natural light in this house, and there's like the whole, almost every window you look out, there's a view of the ocean, except for straight out the front. Because, you know, out either side, out the back, it's just all ocean views, which is really nice. You know, I imagine in real life this would be a very expensive property. It isn't. It actually is in the game too for The Sims. It's an expensive property and also a dangerous one. You know, it's living on the edge there, quite literally on the edge. But you know, just hope there's no bad weather. And here I'm putting in some landscaping, like I said I would. Some nice and lovely blue, pink, and red flowers, and also a bunch of palm trees, obviously. Yeah, obviously none in the water, because that would be a little weird. I put them very near to the water, but not quite. And again, like I said, it's not entirely realistic to have all these bushes and stuff growing in the sand. I mean, it's possible, I'm sure, but very unlikely. You know, I think it looks nice, though, so that's why I did it. And I just like everything to be detailed, so for me, it kind of had to have landscaping there. And, you know, I tried not to overdo it, like, by making, like, a rainforest kind of area, like, all super lush, because then it wouldn't blend in with the rest of the beach. Anyway, here's the rowboat. I just put in a simple rowboat. I didn't want a large boat to, like, obscure the house, because, you know, that wouldn't be too nice. So, just a simple rowboat. If your Sims can, they can row out to the island. There's an island kind of far away. I don't even know if Sims can go there. That's where the lighthouse is in Sunset Valley. There's that, like, island off the shore. And it's actually quite far away. Obviously, it was impossible to get to. I don't know if Sims can swim to it, because I know with Seasons, they let Sims swim in the ocean. I don't know if Sims can just swim to the island, or if they need to take a boat. I don't know, because then obviously Seasons and Island Paradise came out way, you know, after the base game. So I don't know if they designed that island to be visited. It might not be able to be visited by Sims. It could be unroutable terrain or whatever they call it. You know, so might not work, but it'd be cool if you could. I don't know, I never tried it. I should try at some point. But anyway, here I'm just putting in a bit of detail, so with some columns. I love doing this in The Sims 4. I really wish The Sims 3 lets you kind of snap columns onto the corners of walls, but you can't do that in The Sims 3, so I just kind of use move objects to kind of place them in there, and they look good because it adds a nice bit of detail, you know? It adds a bit of wood trim on the sides of those kind of areas, and I like doing that. And here I'm just putting in some hipped roofs there just to kind of make it look a bit more realistic with the thatched roofing. And yeah, I think we're almost done with the exterior, because I think the landscaping is finished. I don't really come back later and do more, so I think this is pretty much it. I put a little fake window up there just for a bit of detail, you know, just something up there. And I think we're done with the exterior, hopefully. So moving on to the interior now, putting in some doors, obviously. It's always good to have some doors. Oh, right, I told you I was going to put a balcony here. So here's the balcony off the master bedroom. It's just a fairly simple balcony that affords wonderful ocean views. So, you know, your Sims can wander out there. I also put the bed on the wall directly opposite of that view. So, like, if your Sims are in bed, they can kind of look out the window, or the door, I guess, and see the ocean. Very nice. And yeah, so putting in the fireplaces, obviously, you know, gotta have that nice fire when it's burning hot outside, you know. I don't know, I guess it could get pretty chilly at the beach in the winter, possibly. Depends on where Sunset Valley is in relation to the equator, you know, like New Jersey and I guess Maine. If you go like far north, they would get cold in the winter at the beaches. So, you know, let's imagine this is somewhere northern, and northerly, more northerly than, I don't know. Yeah, but there's palm trees. I guess there's palm trees. Yeah, I guess palm trees seem more tropical. I don't know if Sunset Valley is supposed to be tropical or if it's supposed to be, you know, more, I don't know if it's supposed to be like more like a Florida kind of climate there, or more like a, you know, New Jersey kind of area, like farther up. I mean, obviously, I don't know if it's even based off the United States. I'd imagine it probably was based off an American town. Like, you know, Monte Vista was supposed to be like Italian, and Hidden Springs feels kind of European. It kind of, it reminds me like the Switzerland for some reason. I don't know why. I guess it's like the mountains. But Sunset Valley has always, you know, seemed kind of like an American kind of town. But I don't know where it would be. I feel like, you know what, I kind of feel like it's in between Florida and, like the south and north. It's kind of like maybe, I don't know, what's in between there? North Carolina? South Carolina, maybe? I don't know. What am I? I don't know. Who knows? But, who knows? But, whatever. It doesn't really matter. Let's just say it gets cold in the winter and you'll need, your Sims will need fireplaces, you know? I mean, The Sims 3 with Seasons does have snow in Sunset Valley, so there you go. You know, you'll need the fireplaces. So anyhow, that's the kitchen, not finished, but partly finished. And this is the little half bathroom I just plopped in there. And here we go, here comes some of the lovely paneling. You can see I'm experimenting with different directions of the paneling, I think. This wall's horizontal, but the other wall might have vertical, I'm not sure. Anyway, I put a little bit of pebbles there on the wall behind the oven. It's kind of a nice little backsplash. I think it looks pretty classy. Actually, no, I do the rest of the walls in the kitchen with tile, so never mind. But I do, you know, mix up the vertical and horizontal slats depending on the walls in the room and stuff. Anyway, this is the last room I do, is right here. I was going to try to fit a pool table, but it just seemed a little too large. So I ended up putting a foosball table in here. There you go. And I come back to that. Oh, I don't know why I was putting a trampoline in the ocean. Anyway, I come back to that room last, so I don't know. Anyway, I also put an air conditioner in just for sake of realism. You know, a little close to the water there, but whatever. And I think that's the bit of outdoor decorations almost done here. I also put a fountain out the back of the house. Anyhow, coming back inside, putting in some more lighting. And I'm not sure what I'm doing here. Who knows? Anyway, putting in some nice wood flooring. And back in the kitchen, finally to finish it up. So I put in some nice details here with this little shelf. And I also put in a little cabinet thingy up there, which you'll see. Also a shelf over there. There's a little, like, I guess it's a cabinet. That's a shelving unit. And a little fire alarm, burglar alarm, phone, you know, all your typical doodads and thingamabobs. Just getting the colors right. This is the pets' cabinets and counters, which actually look really nice. I like the wood fridge and the wood oven kind of look nice. They look kind of more cozy, you know, that was the vibe I was going for. There's a lot of wood in this house, too. You know, it's wood stilts. You can see a lot of the walls are wood. Actually, like half the walls in the house are probably wood paneling. And then you have, you know, the wood plated appliances. They're not like made of wood, you know, they're just like a panel that goes over it. But you know, it looks pretty nice. I'm pretty pleased with this house, if I do say so myself. And you can see you're putting in a bit of tile on the walls just so it looks nice. And yeah, I think we're almost done the kitchen there. I think we are done the kitchen. How exciting. And yeah, beautiful. I actually love the green countertops in the kitchen. I think it looks exquisite. I don't know why. I just love that color. It's like a turquoise. It's like a tealish green. It just looks really nice. Anyway, this room here is... Oh, well, we're about to go to the breakfast room. The room I was just in is the breakfast room. This is still the kitchen, obviously. I thought I was done, but I was mistaken. And I just put in a few things, bits and bobs around the place. You know, a bit of plants and kind of a sailboat thing there, which looks pretty nice. And a candle. Flower, never mind. Anyway, this is the breakfast room, which is lovely. The views in here are stunning. Some of the best in the house because this has wraparound windows, faces out to the ocean. We have this nice little four-seater table here. So obviously this is just off the kitchen. It's kind of like an informal, you know, like I said, breakfast room. Obviously you can eat anything in there, not necessarily just breakfast, but you know, that's the idea anyway, is that it's kind of an informal dining space. The formal dining room is off the living room, kind of across the house. So that's kind of for entertaining purposes, and this is just for like the family to eat at that table, which is pretty nice. And oh, I put a little flamingo outside, how nice. Anyway, in back in the kitchen, I'm actually putting in some more details here and some nice ores in the living room. For some reason, I've put pianos in almost all of my houses recently. It's kind of crazy. I don't know why, I just love putting pianos. I can't play the piano, but I think it looks nice. It looks very fancy, so I like putting it in houses. So this house has a piano there in the living room, and it has lovely ocean views there. And putting in a bit of a tile floor under the fireplace, just so it looks bright, I guess. I don't know. I feel like it should. I mean, the fireplaces have a hearth there already, but I like putting tile under it anyway. And here I'm just putting in some more windows to the master bedroom there, because it seemed a little dark. And yeah, this is the master bedroom. There's the bed, which I kind of center with the door that leads out to the balcony. And also painting up the landing here, you can see I got some wood paneling in there. And back in the living room, we're gonna actually do some furnishing now. So the living room is a large room, actually. You can see it's pretty big, probably the biggest room in the house. And you have a pretty large section of it taken up by the piano. But I really love this sectional sofa I put in here. Yeah, obviously it's just two normal sofas put together. It's nothing new. I mean, obviously people have done this for quite a while. I think I've done it before too. Not in a house. I don't think I've done it in a house build before, but I have done that before. It looks nice. And here's just my corner of plants. I don't think these doors off the living room are usable. I think the piano blocks one of them and the plants blocks the other, but it's all right. You know, there's plenty more doors to go out of, but they're kind of there just for decoration. I guess I imagine those doors aren't for actually going through. They're kind of more just to open up and let kind of some sea breezes come in, you know. Anyway, you can see there's a lovely table behind the couch with a yellow horse on it. You know, all my Sims 3 houses have a yellow horse for some reason. I don't know why. I've just always just been, I mean, for years, I've been putting that yellow horse in all of my Sims 3 house builds. So here it is, making its return, obviously. It has to be in here. And I'm just putting in some nice chairs there. I think I changed the color of them. Maybe not. Maybe I already did. I don't know. But they look a little too bluish. I'm not sure. But, yeah, I love the color of the couch, too. Yeah, I will change the chair colors. They're a little shocking. But I love the color of the couch because... There, I just changed the chairs. You know, it's kind of like a mossy green, and I think that it just looks really well good with the kind of golden color on the walls. It's a very classy room. This house isn't necessarily beachy. It's just kind of more like a cozy home that happens to be on the beach. I mean, the outside, definitely, with the thatched roof, looks beachy. But the inside, well, the kitchen, I think the wood, I think what really kind of gives, like, completes the look is the wood paneling on the walls. It's not like a 1970s horror show wood paneling. You know, it's a very nice whitewashed, you know, wide planked paneling that looks really classy. And I think that the whitewashing, like the really nice, like, white wood and, like, the soft kind of muted colors look really beachy. You know, this, like, the style, though, isn't necessarily, like, I didn't use, like, all the kind of, like, nautical themed items like I did, like, years ago. I used, what was it, Coral Cottage, I think, if any of you have watched that video, I don't know. That's like 2 years old, over 2 years old now. But I really like that build anyway. But I use like all like a lot of like the oh I should no I should have used is that wonderful bookcase that's shaped like a boat. Anyway, I use like all those kinds of objects in that house. I didn't really do that in this house. It's just like normal furniture, normal, you know, wood tones and everything. But it's just kind of the color scheme that makes it look kind of like it belongs at the beach. Anyhow, I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just trying to come up with some rationale for my design. But you can see here, this is the lovely dining room, which is the formal dining room. And it has a nice 8-seater table, a little buffet serving area here I'm putting some objects on. And just some mats in the entrance hall, so you know you don't track sand in. Though I imagine the amount of sand that would be in this house would be insane, because yeah, it'd just be a lot of sand. Because you know people tracking in sand from the beach, and it would just be a mess. But anyway, that's for your Sims to deal with. Sims can deal with the non-existent sand that gets tracked into the house. Anyhow. That's the main rooms done. We're moving on now to the study, which is a small room, but it has a fireplace and very nice, warm, cozy furnishings here. We have a bunch of bookshelves, obviously, as it is a study. And I also put in a nice kind of desk and a little reclining, not reclining chair, but like a chair with a footrest where Sims can kind of kick back and read a book if they want to, I suppose. You know, well, actually, it's up to you, really, because Sims do have some level of free will, but not much, to be honest. Just enough free will so they can survive. But anyway, you can see here, there's the nice desk, a bit of a computer, and putting in some nice curtains. I love those curtains. Those curtains are from... What are they from? They're from the bedroom set. Something romantic, something bedroom set. I can't remember what it's called, but it was that bedroom set that came out a couple years, like more like, I don't know, like 4 years ago or something. Maybe even more. Maybe it was 5 years ago. Who knows? But that bedroom set, romantic bedroom something, master bedroom set, I can't remember, it was a stuff pack. That's gonna bug me now. Master suite stuff, that's what it was, right? Master suite stuff, I think. Anyway, those curtains came with it. They're wonderful curtains. The only objects I think I used from that pack, wonderful. They just look nice. I don't know, I like the curtains that are like separate pieces at each end, because then you can make them fit any size window. It's lovely. But anyhow, I finished the study. Wow, I was too busy talking about curtains. So the study is done. This is the half bathroom on the main floor. It's fairly basic. Got a nice little sink and a toilet and nice pebble flooring, I suppose, which makes it fancy. Also, I don't know if that would hurt your feet, but those pebbles, who knows? Anyway, looks kind of nice and very simple bathroom. Wonderful. So I think we're going to move on upstairs, possibly. I'm not sure. I know I don't do the bonus room until later. So yeah, we're gonna go upstairs here. This is the upstairs guest bathroom. So this bathroom is, you know, fairly simple. It has a tub shower combination, nice sink, and a toilet. Unfortunately, I couldn't fit a double sink in this bathroom, and I could also, well, no, let me rephrase that. I couldn't fit a double sink in the master bathroom either. So yeah, it just the rooms are too small, but it's all right. And you can see here, fairly simple, nice tile colors there. Kind of, you know, muted tones, and a bit of towels, and a bit of a toilet roll there, and some details on the countertop, also some magazines, if your Sims needs some amusement or entertainment, I don't know, while using the toilet. Anyway, this is the guest bedroom. So the guest bedroom is fairly simple, you know, you have some greens, and has a balcony, which overlooks the beach, not the ocean though, because it looks out the front of the house, but you can probably see the ocean from it, because there's a lot of ocean around this house. And yeah, it's a very simple bedroom, it's got a nice green color scheme, like I said, and there's the dresser, two dressers, very, very spacious, plenty of space for clothes, and also I'm putting in a bit of a mirror as well, and some plant objects, you know, just strewn around, not really strewn around, but in the corner. And a nice chair. I think that's from Diesel Stuff, and it's also a very expensive chair. I think it's like one of the most expensive chairs in the game, just because, I suppose. Anyway, it looks nice though. So also, the house is already at 158,000 simoleons, 160 now. So yeah, I think my estimate of around 200,000 is probably accurate, maybe a bit less, maybe 190,000 simoleons. I don't know, it's an expensive house, that's all my houses tend to be. Also, if you can hear like a lawnmower, that's because my neighbors are getting their lawn mowed. You probably can't hear, because like whenever I say, oh, well, actually I don't say it often, because it doesn't tend to happen, but if I do say, like, oh, excuse that noise. And I listened back to the recording. There is, like, no noise you can hear. So maybe you can't hear it. But if you do, just pretend it's not there. You know, it's, like, always, you know, it is 3:30 p.m. So, it's about the time that they pop by and they, like, do it. Oh, it's, like, constant. I don't even know. It's, like, in my neighborhood, there's always a lawn being mowed in the afternoon. Somewhere. It's, like, it's ridiculous. I don't know. It's very annoying, too, because it's very noisy. But anyways, I feel like it's across the street, judging by the sound. But I swear they were just here a few days ago. Anyway, so this is the master bedroom. We have a lovely fireplace with a TV over it, and this wonderful kind of greenish wood color, which is kind of interesting. And the stunning views of the ocean, obviously, which is lovely. And I'm also putting in some plants and other things in the room, kind of make it look fancy schmancy. And there's like a little ottoman thingy at the end of the bed. It's really a coffee table, but I think it's like an ottoman type thing at the end of the bed there. And there's an alarm clock. Still don't know why The Sims 4 doesn't have alarm clocks. I don't get that. But The Sims 3 has it, so I threw them in. And putting in some more things. And little doohickeys and doodads and thingamabobs and all that kind of stuff. Thingamagummies, you know. All the words for items that really don't serve much purpose. Anyway, there's the closet. I love doing closets like that. They look very nice. And this here is the master bathroom, which is a little smaller than I wish it would be. I kind of wish it was a bit bigger, but yeah, I couldn't fit a double sink in, but it's alright. We have the tub shower there. I had to move the door to fit the bed, you know, centered with the door to the balcony. So then this door to the bathroom is kind of in a weird place. I had to put the shower in a weird place, which meant that there wasn't room for double sinks. So it's kind of unfortunate, but anyhow, you know, you don't need two sinks. Who needs two sinks anyway? And just putting some details in the bathroom, obviously. Actually, we're coming near the end. There's about 6 or so minutes left of this video. Obviously, there's going to be some screenshots, you know, before the end of the video, you know, obviously. Kind of weird if the screenshots were after the end of the video, because then there would be no video for the screenshots to be in. But anyway, yeah, there'll be some screenshots coming up after this building portion. We have one more bedroom to do, and then the bathroom, and, you know, a few other things. But we're very close. Hopefully you would like this house. You know, I think it's quite fantastic, if I do say so myself, but that's a little bit self-congratulatory. So, you know, tell me what you think in the comments below. And also, be sure to follow me on Twitter. You know, I tweet out, like, pictures of my progress in certain houses and, you know, updates and things like that. And I think that'd be really fantastic if you just check out my Twitter feed. So, yeah, that's a shameless plug there. You can find it in the link in the description. You can find the link in the description below. There's also going to be a link to my Instagram account too, where I occasionally post photographs of hopefully artistic photographs. And yeah, there's a link there as well. And here we're just doing the kids' room, which is a fairly simple bedroom. It has some toys and stuff. I love this wallpaper I have in here. It's quite fantastic. I love the stripes and the colors. It's very nice. And we also have a bunk bed, a couple beanbag chairs. I love the shark one. It's pretty cool. Also put a desk here by the bathroom door. There's no room for a chair, so you can't really use it, but it looks nice. And yeah, so also putting in a lamp and some details and things of that nature. And yeah, put in a rug and a toy chest and all the kids related objects, you know, that makes sense anyway. There's your pirate's chest that looks like a toy a toy chest that looks like a pirate's chest. And obviously all the obligatory posters, so. Gotta get those in there, naturally. So we're gonna throw those about the room. Also, I love that Gnome Crossing kind of sign. It looks so cool. But anyway, this is the ensuite bathroom for the kids' room. It's a fairly simple bathroom. It's got just a shower. There's no tub shower because I didn't want to put the sink against the window there. So just a stand-up shower. Got your toilet. Got your sink. You know, all your goodies in here, I guess. I don't know. I don't know why bathroom fixtures and fittings are goodies, but anyway. So yeah, there you go. It's wonderful, beautiful, lovely bathroom. Just great, you know, just wonderful. All kind of good adjectives in that bathroom. Well, about that bathroom, I don't know. Anyway, great. That bathroom's done. So now we're gonna work on the hallway. Here's a few things. And our last room in the house is the bonus room, which I said, I don't really do much in here. I got the foosball tables, a dartboard, bookshelf, some plants, and a little sitting area, so fairly simple, but it's a nice room to have. You know, your Sims can do stuff in here. If you want to put a chess table, that's kind of the room for it, and your Sims can do some skill building, have some fun. Just a kind of nice room to have. Also, the study is off of this room as well, and yeah, I think it's nice. Also, a grandfather clock for a bit of fanciness. You know, gotta have the I gotta have that little bit of fancy going on. And yeah, so we're gonna do the outside here. We're almost finished. There's plenty more house builds like this on my channel if you are interested in checking them out. And, you know, I hope you enjoyed this house build. I hope you stick around for the screenshots, like I said earlier. And if you enjoy my videos and if you like my houses, I'd greatly appreciate it if you consider subscribing. It would help me out a lot. And yeah, so here I'm just putting in the final touches, and I'll see you next time.